Hello, good morning, and welcome to my little bit of world. Today is a bit of a cheat, I'm afraid. There is no photograph for you. However, consider this a selfie. Right, I'm here actually today to show you how I did the work in Photoshop for that photograph called Condiments of the Season. The one with the yellow pepper pouring the salt out. So with no more ado, let's get cracking, shall we?
Right, this is the finished picture, or the one we hope we're going to get. And I can close that down now because we're finished with it. We'll be doing this in a second. No, I don't want to save any changes. Here are the two pictures. There's one of the pepper and the salt on the plate, and there's one of the salt being poured onto the plate. Long exposure to make the salt show it's flowing, shaking because the salt was rather soggy. Let's make a little start. Now, if we have a look at this, we'll notice that I've shot it on a black background, but the black isn't quite right. So we need to make that black as we can get it. Now, to do this, we're going to use the levels command. Now, in Photoshop CS6 and all other versions, it's under Image Adjustment Levels, and it pulls up this box here. I don't know what it is in Photoshop Elements, but I can tell you there is a shortcut that will get you to that same dialog box that works in Photoshop Elements and in Photoshop. That shortcut is Control and L. If you're following on a Mac, that is Command and L. This shows the levels. It's a nice little histogram showing all the pixels that are black right through to all the pixels that are white. Now, to make it blacker, we will do a very, very simple change. I could drag this slider here and do it that way, or I can grab hold of the black eyedropper, choose an area that isn't black, and say I want that to become black. Bang! And there it is. It's black. Say OK. Now we'll go to the other picture and we'll do something similar. Control and L, Command and L, and this time I will do it using the slider. I'm going to grab hold of this and say this is currently black. I want to make this area in here, which would normally be grey, black. Look at that. I could go way over the top, but I don't want to do that. I just want to make sure that it's nice and black. Like that. Okay. Next, we need to combine these two pictures so that we can make all the changes we need on one picture. So we need to either do a Select All, or you'll notice there was the shortcut Control and A, which will do the same. Then we need to do an Edit Copy, or Control and C is the shortcut. So I'll do Control and C, that's Command and C on a Mac. I'll come back to this picture here and I will do an Edit Paste, which is Control and V, and it pastes a new layer. Look at this. Layer 1 on top of the background. The background hasn't disappeared. It's still there. If I turn the visibility on and off, you will see the layer is there. Okay. We don't need this picture anymore, the pepper picture anymore. So I'm going to close that down. I don't want to save any changes to it. We're back to now this one picture. To make life easier so I know what I'm doing, I'm going to rename this layer. I'm going to double click where it says layer 1 and I'm going to type in pepper. I'm going to select the background layer and I'm going to do the same there and change the name of that to salt. There we go. Just to show that all the layers are here and things are underneath, I'm going to click on this top layer here to make it the active layer, and I'm going to lower the opacity. I'm going to make it thinner so you can actually see through it to the layer below. There's a reason for this, because I want to get the pepper in more or less the right sort of place for the rest of the work to be done. and I can now see where I need to move it to. Move requires the Move tool. There it is. And with the pepper layer selected, not the salt layer, the pepper layer, I'm going to move the pepper layer to roughly where I want it to be so that the salt looks like it's coming out of the end of the pepper. Okay. Notice it's shuffled all the other stuff around, but don't worry about that. We'll be getting around that. Here we go. We're going to bring the opacity of that top layer right back. And we are now roughly in the right position to start doing what we want to do. Now, I could very easily use an eraser. Get a nice eraser, make it a reasonable size, make sure it's nice and soft, hardness of 0%, and I could erase through the salt. That might be the answer if you're on Photoshop Elements, because Photoshop Elements isn't quite as clever as Photoshop. But this does mean, if you make a mistake, oh whoops, I've cut a hole through it. There's the hole I've cut through it. I've just turned the visibility of the layer off below. And I'd have to go, oh dear, and go back. This is why I like using Photoshop, and in the latest version of Photoshop Elements you can do this too. We're going to use a layer mask. A layer mask, I just click on this little button here, is this area here. It's got a little frame around the outside to show it's active. And what we do is, we pretend this is a piece of paper and we're going to cut a hole through it so we can see what's below, what's there. And to do this, because obviously we can't use a pair of scissors, we're going to paint on this layer mask. Not the picture, which is now outlined here, but on the layer mask. And to do this, we need to have black and white set as our foreground and background colours. There's the default. Click on this little double icon and you get white as the foreground, black as the background. We need to swap it so that black is the foreground color and white is the background color. We now need to get a nice brush. There we go. Select the brush tool. If you can't see it, it's because it's hidden around behind one of these, but brush tool. Coming up to the palette up here, we want to make sure we've got a reasonable size. Yes, about 100 odd pixels, 120, something of that sort, and make it a nice soft edge, so we bring the hardness right down. We click off that tool palette, and there is our brush with a nice soft edge, all ready to go. On the pepper layer, on the pepper layer mask, notice the little frame appearing to say that's the bit that's active, I'm now going to paint black over the area I want to cut through. Let me just do a little bit of this, and then I will stop, have a look at the layer mask. I have painted black on that layer mask, and that allows me to see through to the layer below. I'm looking at the salt from the layer below. Now I'm going to come up here and carry on painting black onto my layer mask until I get sort of roughly there. I'm going to bring it up to the top. Oh, I'm using a stylus and pad, by the way. I'm not using a mouse. A stylus and a pad is so much easier. It's more control. And I'm going to bring that up to there. Right, there you go. Now, why am I using a layer mask? Let me show you what happens if I make a mistake. I'm going to carry on painting down here, and whoops, and other Anglo-Saxon words, look what I've done. I've gone too far. And I need to correct that. My layer mask needs to be changed. And the simple way is you swap to white, and on your layer mask again, you paint out that little bit of black you already painted in. And there you go. You have corrected a mistake. If you had the eraser tool, it wouldn't work so well. You'd have to go back and say stop erasing. With this, it's so dynamic because you are just cutting through the picture here via the mask down to the layer below. we're almost finished now. All we need to do now is, when I did the move of this top layer, you'll notice it moved a bit of an edge there. So we need to get rid of that using the crop tool. Crop. Unconstrained. And all I need to do is move where I want the crop to happen. I've got a bit of a blank bit down there. And that's about it, I think. I'm going to press Enter, or you can, as someone says, click the tick to make it stick. That's that. And we can do a File, Save As, choose where you want to put it, make sure it's a JPEG, and say Finished Shot, or whatever you want to call it. You can call it Fred if you like, and Save. I tend to save with a quality of 10 or so. Okay. And basically, that's the job done. So easy.
There now. Wasn't that easy? Probably took me a little bit longer to do that, telling you all the shortcuts, than it did for me to do it in real life. Okay. That's it for now. I hope you've enjoyed it. Do leave me a comment. And if you don't like it, leave me a comment. I may do more of these later. So that's the end of the show, folks. There's only one thing left. Bring on the dancing meerkats. Da 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 da